In this particular program, I am going to show you how you use the fgets to read from the standard input, which is your keyboard, as well as the use of fputs to write the contents you have read from the keyboard one line at a time. So what I have done is I have declared fptr as a pointer to a file type of data structure. I have defined an array of characters called as buffer, whose length is 80 characters. The name of my file is fgets_test.txt. I'm opening it in write mode. If there is no problem opening the write mode, this part is never going to get executed. Then what I'm doing is I'm asking the user to enter one line at a time. So he can keep entering lines, and the minute he enters on a blank line, he just presses the enter key. That's when it indicates that he's no longer interested to enter any lines. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to say do. And using fgets, I'll show you how to read data. So I'm going to say fgets. Okay. Then first thing what I need to do is I need to first define the stream. The destination stream is going to be my buffer. Then I'm going to read 80 minus 1. I'm going to read 79 characters because I need one space for the null. And what is my input stream? My input stream is my standard in. So the way to understand fgets is this buffer represents your target where the data is going to be stored. This represent max minus one character because you need one space for the null character. Standard in represents your source of input, which is your keyboard. Now what I'm going to do here is using fputs, I am simply going to write the buffer onto the location referred to by the file pointer. Alright. Now if you see here, every time I read a line, I am going to write that line to the location referred by the file pointer. Now, how long should this continue? This should continue as long as I am not entering a blank line. The minute I enter a blank line, the first character on the line happens to be an enter, that's when I am going to stop reading. All right. So let's try to chop this off and get this close here. So what I'm trying to do here is I am reading one line from the keyboard, writing it to this particular file fgets test. And as long as I don't enter as the first character on the new line, I am fine. I can keep entering. The minute I enter as the first character on the new line, then I am going to come and close this particular file. Just to make it more clear, I can just put it in brackets so that you know that this location pointed to by buffer is, as long as it's not equal to the enter key, I am fine. So let me just copy this particular piece of code, take it onto this online GDB compiler and paste it. So it should create a file called as fgets_test.txt. Somewhere below the F9, you will see that particular file being created. So let's try to compile it first and let's see if it tries to run. All right, there is a certain problem. I have not included the header file stdio.h. Okay, stdio.h. So this is more like a copying mistake. Now let's try to compile it and see if things go well. All right, now it's fine. So it is telling me keep entering lines, and to stop, just press the enter key. So I'll say welcome to GEHU. This is my first line. Okay, then I can say Bhimtal rocks. All right, like this. Then I'm going to say, Haldwani. Haldwani is a great place. Okay, is a great place. All right, bye. I can write bye here. All right. Now, if I want to stop entering data on this next line, I'll just press the enter key. So now if you see, it has stopped any data input and the file has got created, and you can see whatever I entered was created in this particular file. Welcome to GEGUHU, Bhimtal rocks, Haldwani is a great place, and why. So using this particular approach, I am able to basically create a file. Okay, I'm able to basically create a file and write data one line at a time. So whenever you need to read the entire data one line at a time, use fgets. Whenever you need to write one line at a time, use fputs, because it will write spaces, everything, and so on. So this explanation or this demo should be looked in conjunction with the prior video where a detailed explanation of this particular thing has been done. So I hope you understand how you can read and write lines onto a file using fgets and fputs.